Hey, everyone. Welcome back to the Pace Studios. We are now live with Doyle Bramhall II. Doyle, thanks for being here, man.
Thanks for having us on.
Yeah, I feel absolutely justified and accurate in saying that you are a guitar hero, and we are stoked that you are here today doing this thing. So Shades is the album. It's coming out tomorrow. It's out tomorrow on Provogue. So congratulations on the release of that. And we're looking forward to hearing four songs off of this. Three originals and a Dylan song. And can you tell us what you're going to do first?
Yeah, I am going to do a song called Everything You Need, which is a song that I wrote with Adam Minkoff, who is normally a bandmate, but he's out with Amy Helm at the moment, who I think just played the show.
Yeah, she was just in on Monday.
Yeah. And Althea Grace, who's another songwriter, and Gabby Sherba. And I was fortunate enough to call Eric up and ask if he wanted to play on this, and he said he would love to, so I flew out to see him in Ohio and recorded him in about an hour on this track, and it's coming out tomorrow. I'm very excited for this new journey.
Thank you.
Yeah, that sounds great. Thanks for coming and doing this here. We appreciate you taking the time to come preview these four tunes off of Shades, which if you're just joining us, it's out on Provogue tomorrow. So congratulations on the release, and thanks for playing these songs here.
Yeah, man. Thanks for letting us rehearse here.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Of course. Use it for what it's worth. So I'm not sure where you guys are going, what song you're going to play next, but I imagine that this is going to be a good segue to that next song regardless. Can you talk a little bit about the cast of musicians that you collaborated with? I know you mentioned Adam Minkoff earlier, but can you talk, I mean, there's a massive laundry list of collaborators on this album and throughout your career. Can you talk about a little bit of who you crossed paths with on this record?
Yeah, I mean, it's just... I guess I've had the great fortune of working with a lot of amazing musicians and songwriters and singers and you know, over the years. And I've always sort of steered clear of doing guests on records because, to me, like, you know, I don't know what period in music it became a thing to like have guests on, but it started becoming sort of, I don't know, just feeling like it was sort of a novelty thing to me. So I always sort of, you know, stayed away from doing that because I didn't want to just like capitalize on all the, you know, different people I knew or played with or whatever. And I wanted to like stand on my own legs. So,
sure.
But, you know, for this one, it really just each song that I wrote as I was going along, you know, they just sort of, you know, spoke to me. And Everything You Need, after I finished recording it, I just thought it would be a song that Eric would really dig. And I sort of heard us playing back and forth on it, you know, before I actually even called him up. So, and... the next song I'm going to do is a song called Searching for Love, and I wrote this with Nora Jones. And this one was a pretty deliberate song because I wanted to write something from scratch with her. I wanted her, not only her musical sensibilities, but I think she's a great songwriter and she's a brilliant piano player and singer. So I just wanted a song to be an amalgam of what I do and what she does and see what we could do together. I had a couple of other guests on the record. I did a song called Going, Going, Gone, which I'll do in the set. And that was a song that I had done for a Greg Allman tribute after he passed away. And after I performed the show, or performed that song at this show we did, it just felt like a really, it had like a life of its own, and I felt like it would be really sweet and sort of deep kind of tribute for Greg, who I'd played with before and made a record with. And then at the same time, I was thinking it would be really, really special to have Derek Trucks and Susan Tedeschi and actually all of the TTB band on it. So I asked if they were down for doing a collaboration on that, and flew down to Jacksonville to record that one with them. And and then the collaboration I did with the Greyhounds was just sort of hanging out in Austin.
Yeah.
In this little courtyard, which is, I think...
The astronaut still?
Huh?
They have the astronaut still? Have you ever seen that dude who shows up at Greyhound shows dressed like an astronaut sometimes?
No, they have the guy on the horse.
There is Sam. An astronaut mega fan that just is there sometimes.
No, I haven't seen that. But yeah, so my sister actually has a hair salon. And it's on the back side of the Greyhound studio called Bud's Studio. And then there's like a coffee shop. So you have a lot of, you know, Austin people hanging out and artists and musicians. And one day I was just hanging out there with my sister and happened to run into those guys and said, hey, we should do a song. And Andrew from the Greyhounds was like, yeah, come over, let's do it. And so I just went in the studio. We wrote a song in about an hour and called up whoever was available in town and cut it, and that was it. It was pretty organic Austin experience.
Amazing. Over tacos and Topo Chico, I imagine.
A lot of Topo Chico.
Right? Yeah. Well, we're looking forward to hearing everything that's about to happen. So you doing Searching for Love next?
Yeah.
Awesome. We'd love to hear it.
All right. We'll be right back. where are you at, Nora?
Dude, that sounds great, man. Thanks again for coming by and playing these four songs from Shades for us today. And internet, if you are just joining us right now, Shades is the album that's out on Provo tomorrow. And so, Doyle, congratulations on that. And so I was reading that you said that this was, you feel comfortable with yourself in your own skin here on this record, particularly. And I was wondering what, I mean, you've had 10 lifetimes of musical experience. I mean, from being in the Fabulous Thunderbirds at the age of 18, being collaborating with, being in the, forming the band with Double Trouble, Archangels, right? I mean, you've had so much musical experience. What do you think it was? Why had you not been comfortable until just now? Or was there something that happened that made you particularly comfortable with this record?
Did I say that?
I read that.
No, I'm kidding.
Somebody told me that.
Yeah, I just...
The internet told
me that. I just
that.
Meant, you know, when I was first asked that question, it was more about, you know, being a musician, a singer, a songwriter, a producer, and I was saying that I felt really comfortable and just sort of like I know what I'm doing now, which, you know, I spent many years not really knowing what I was doing and not knowing necessarily what the point was to a lot of stuff. I mean, in personally and in my career. So I don't know. I did sort of have an epiphany moment where everything just started to make sense to me. And I don't know, you know, what had to happen to get to that place, but it just seemed like, I don't know, there was some electricity going on and it just sort of like, you know,
good.
Struck me.
Good. Well, I'm stoked that happened. And you certainly, obviously, put in your 10,000 hours, probably put in your 80,000 hours into it.
Well, I don't know.
I can't do that math quickly. It's just, I guessed. I don't know.
When do I become a genius?
75,000 hours. You're there, man. Thanks again for coming and doing this. We just heard two off of Shades, and you're going to do four songs today. Can you tell us what you're doing next?
I'm going to do a song called Love and Pain, which I wrote with actually a New York songwriter, Brooklyn guy named Aki Bermis. And we wrote it. We were in the studio recording it in Brooklyn Recording Studios here, and as we were recording this song, the Las Vegas mass shooting happened, and I don't know, it just sort of gutted everybody, and you know, it had become such a ubiquitous thing, and it was just happening so frequently, and I don't know, it just sort of fit exactly what the song felt like emotionally or viscerally to us. It sort of felt like it was a perfect sort of vehicle for the lyrics that that Aki came up with for this. So yeah, that's basically what it's for.
Come on, man, as in the saints go to war till it all burns down.
Man, this sounds great. I'm having a great day. Thanks for coming and doing this.
Yeah, thanks, man.
Yeah.
If you're happy.
I am. I wasn't earlier, but I'm good now.
All right.
Yeah. Thanks, man.
Well,
so
I'm happy now.
Good, good. The internet has some good questions today. Matt Nip from the internet wants to know more about the what guitar are you playing, and how are there any setup notes that you did specifically to that work well for the style of guitar you're playing? What are you playing? What guitar are you playing?
Oh, this thing? Let me see. Hold on. It's a Heritage. This is a Heritage. What's it called? 535. And, yeah, it's a really special guitar for me.
Clearly.
I don't know. A friend of mine in Dallas, he owns a record store, a guitar store there. And he said that this guy had died, and he had like 40 left-handed guitars. And he said, there's one guitar I think you'd dig. And so he showed it to me. I played it. It sounded really good. So I brought it here and played it just now for you.
Amazing.
I don't know what the setup is. I do know that I did travel to New York recently and opened the case, and this headstock was completely broken off the guitar. So
oh, man.
Redo that.
Who did you fly? What airline?
I usually fly American.
Ooh. Yeah.
All right.
Brother.
But
beware.
Yeah, I think this was American.
All right. Noted. Man, this is sounding great. And we get there's a bonus song also. You're going to play a fourth song today off of Shades, which, again, if you're just joining us, that's coming out tomorrow. And so can you tell us about what you're doing fourth?
Yeah, I'm going to do a Dylan song called Going, Going, Gone. And it's a song that I performed for a Greg Allman tribute show that I was asked to do. And after I performed this song, I was headed down to Derek Truck's studio in Jacksonville, Florida, and I thought it would be a really, like I said before, a really sweet kind of tribute song to do for Greg because of my connection, because of Derek's connection to him. And so, yeah, let's play it.
Yeah.
I just reached a place with a will I don't bend. There's not much more to be said. It's the top of the end now. I'm going. Yes, I'm going. In the book, on the pages and the text, and I really don't care what happens next. Now I'm going, yes I'm going. Thank you.
Doyle, thanks, man, for coming through and playing these songs. Can we say, before we sign off, can we take a second to introduce the band?
Yeah. Go ahead.
On keys.
Jake Sherman.
Yes.
On the keys.
Thank you very much.
I'm Doyle Bramhall.
Yeah.
The second.
Cool.
Abe Browns on drums. Andy Hess on bass.
All right.
And my good friend Jono. What is it? Linden. Jono Linden.
Right.
On the guitar. And he actually plays in Elizabeth Simon's band, The Catapult.
And usually. Jono, you were here really recently, right? Yeah.
Yeah. She wrote quite a few songs on the new record, too, so that's cool.
Well,
quite the family.
This has been a total pleasure, man. I am a fan of your band. I'm looking forward to diving into Shades more deeply. The record is out tomorrow. So, man, thanks for coming and playing these songs. And tour safe. All the tour dates are up at db2music.com. And so check them out. Hopefully you, the internet, get a chance to see this live because it's something. So, man, thanks for coming and doing this.
All right. Thanks so much for having us on.